In 1969, I were quite young, living in St. Anne's in Nottingham. I mean living, like taking part in the community, trying to make the world around our neighbourhood a better place. We didn't have homeless then. Not us, not then. What we had were overcrowding. The film coming up was made by Stephen Frears. And what you'll see in it is our slums brilliantly photographed in black and white. How we lived then. Five kids to a bed, no lab, no bath, mildew running down the walls. We'd no unemployment then. But the wages you'll hear in this film, they were terrible. Wages not fit for a dog. Homes not fit for a pig. When this film was made, nearly 25 years ago, the Tenants Association I was chairman of tried to stop it being shown. My committee felt the media were using us, exhibiting our poverty for all to see. But within months of this film, all the families you'll see were rehoused. And St. Anne's has been rebuilt quite well, with low-rise houses, because of the pressure we all kept up. The film was well-watched. It's a strong film, maybe because it focuses just on the poverty. It is amazing how we lived then, in what passed for homes. It's changed for the better, only because we all did pull in our ways to make it change. But a long time ago, 1969,
St. Anne's, Nottingham, a damp winter morning. Peter, Mark and David Marriott. Anthony and Evelyn, 11. The children don't sleep well. Sometimes they fall asleep at school.
House is very damp and very cold, because you could have a fire up the chimney back, and the back of the house is freezing.
If the house were less damp, the attic might be pressed into service as a third bedroom, but it has a hole in the roof big enough for a man to climb through. The house has no bathroom, no running hot water, no lavatory indoors, and no proper place to store food.
I have two children that suffer with bronchial asthma, and it's the matter of, we'll say, 4 weeks since Anthony, he came out of hospital with it. The oldest girl is 11. She has to sleep in the same bedroom as four boys, and the oldest boy is 10. I mean, any day, nature could take its part on her, and she's going to be in a terrible mess when she gets out of bed with the four boys in the same bedroom as her. I mean, she's a well-developed girl for an 11. She knows all about the facts of life and everything. The children's clothes, when you fetch them out of the kitchen, you've got to stand there airing them off before they can even put them on, because they're damp. You can't keep nothing at all. Everything's mildewed that's left in that kitchen. You can't keep any food in the cupboard. You can go out there now and smell that cupboard. It's mildew. And if you buy a loaf of bread this morning and I want to use it tomorrow morning, you could smell all fustiness off it. You couldn't possibly use it. Even cornflakes, they go soggy. The only thing you can save is tin stuff, which we don't use a lot of. You see, I buy it fresh every day from the butchers, the greengrocers, or whatever we need. But it means I have to go shopping in the morning to get my husband's dinner in for him to cook at night when he comes home. And I've also got to go shopping on my way home from work to buy something for the supper. I mean, it costs you far more to nip to these little shops to buy, say, a quarter to a pound of sugar than it would to go to one of these supermarkets and buy the whole rations for a week.
Better get up.
The house is owned by the council. Repairs are slow.
There hasn't been a toilet for 6 weeks, and the corporation know this, but they're just not doing nothing about it. They say you've got to be another 2 years, but in 2 years there'll be no house left. We'll be living in the middle of the road. We might as well live there now, anyway. Because it is damn hard work, I'll tell you, having to boil every drop of water you need.
I mean, some people would say you must make more of an effort, you must find a better place to live, you must sort of...
Well, just let anybody say that to me and I'll ask them to come find me one and I'll go and live in it. That's my answer to them.